I've only got like half a cheek on this bed. Is that?
No, you can come in.
I just really
can't see.
I'm gonna suck it in, don't I?
I feel like we're making the apocalypse now with that fucking boom thing we got going there.
It looks like a two cheek.
Jeez Louise.
Looks like a two cheek.
Look at that.
Good to go.
Hi, how are you? I'm Dave Grohl. I'm here on the what's the show?
Video Hits.
Video Hits.
Hey!
And these are my friends Josh and John. And we're here to talk about me. How are you guys doing?
Well, thank you. This is Fuzzy. My name's Dylan.
How's it going?
Have you met Josh and John?
That's the cutest thing ever.
Thank you.
Wow.
Snuggly.
So tall.
This is snuggly and that's cuddly.
This is a very warm and fuzzy moment. I mean, five people sharing a bed,
yeah.
A makeshift couch.
That's nice.
It couldn't get any better than this, Dylan.
I love sharing beds with bands. It's one of my favourite pastimes. Great concert the other night.
Thank you.
You guys are really good musicians and I think you'll go far. Think so? We got a shot?
I think you've got a shot. Thanks, Uncle Dylan.
We've been taking John lessons this whole tour.
Yeah.
I think we're finally starting to get it.
Fantastic.
Rockstar lessons.
I ripped my pants off.
Oh, no.
I didn't know you had a tattoo right there.
Ow!
I never knew that was there.
I ripped my pants off.
Just a little,
hello.
Hey, what else you got hiding in there?
Don't ever shove your camera in my pants again.
And happy belated birthday, John and Dave.
Thank you very much. Capricorn.
Thank you.
Well, actually,
and belated birthday to you.
Yeah, because you're really late with mine.
Yeah.
When's yours?
Yeah.
You're oily.
Way too oily. No, it's amazing to think and conceptualize and pontificate, I don't think that's the right word, about actually how cool this band is. Go with me here. There are representatives from every rock era in this band. I'm sure that the old school has been influenced by the mid school and the new school, and vice versa as well.
You're mid school.
Mid school.
You're elementary. Well, that's. You're the high school, I'm mid school, and you're
I don't know, kinder what?
It is enough to melt your face.
It's all junior high, what are you talking about?
Can you put.
Junior high love.
On the stage, can you put that amazing history out of your minds and be playing the music, or is it like you look over and you see.
No, you know what? I'm always like reciting history while we play. I'm always going through the annals of rock.
1066.
Like, maybe.
Yeah. 1492. 1685.
They're such influential bands, obviously. This is part of the reason that, I mean, obviously, that everyone wanted to come to the concert. But then we get to the concert and we see the music and we go, oh my God, not only is there rock history up on the stage there from every part, but the music actually rocks. And I just couldn't comprehend standing on a stage with any of you people. Not, well, partially because I'm not a rock star.
Well, and also because you're not allowed to get up there.
I'm not allowed to
get up there. What would happen?
No.
There's people that
well,
would keep
that
from happening.
I'd be
you're
allowed.
You're fine.
He's
No, you know, hopefully what people notice is that we have a good time. You know?
Because one thing that all three of us can agree on is that music can turn you prematurely into a bitter old crank.
Sure.
And all three of us are here because we have a really good time together. We've witnessed that, but we don't really have that problem.
Mm. Do you like being called supergroup, or is that an annoying thing to be called?
It doesn't really mean that much, does it? I mean,
I expect you have superpowers, but it's just in my mind.
Well, I prefer super duper.
I like
super duper group.
Yeah, I like stupor group because that's what I want to put people into. Is
stupor group.
It works.
What's that? Can you explain the legend of your formation in the medieval restaurant? This is a legend now. It's in Wikipedia as
there's
a legend.
There's better than that, we were talking about going to this restaurant, the Magic Castle.
Sure.
Yeah. When we get to LA, maybe for their birthdays, you know, where magicians perform.
Good. Love magic.
So people try to reinvent the tux there and stuff. And then we made the record across the street from the Kids Castle, which is across the street from my studio, which is a children's restaurant. But it has dragons, so you have to be kind of careful when you go inside.
Sure.
And then we kind of came together at Medieval Times, which is also a castle.
Mm-hmm.
So this band's been one big castle.
Yeah. It's like one where rock royalty perhaps
rock
should belong.
Rock royalty.
Indeed.
Yeah. What is it like eating food with your bare hands in that rock royalty castle on your birthday?
Well, in my house, we don't eat with regular utensils.
Mm.
You know?
So it's just normal.
Yeah, this is very normal.
He eats from a bowl.
Like a fucking dog!
Lots of soup.
We loved it. We loved the gig. I like the chemistry amongst you up there on stage. It's like you guys
will you
were
come
doing
back
it
again tonight?
Sure.
Because tonight's going to be even better.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, why? Were you disappointed with something last
night? No, it's just better every night.
Honestly, I've never been in a band where every show is better than the night before. And honestly, this band, every show's a little bit different.
Mm.
You know, there's some songs that we can take in different directions, and but every gig's different. It's depending on the audience, the venue, and the vibe. But it seems like every gig we do gets better and better.
Yeah, tonight's going to be the super fun super group version. It's going to be really
super
great.
Super duper.
Yeah.
Gotta have that.
Super duper great.
Hey, when I look at this record, I notice this massive warning sign here. Have
moderate
you seen
impact.
Yeah.
Does this offend you in
moderate
some way?
Moderate impact.
It kind of offends me that the impact would be moderate. I'd rather it be fucking.
Frankly, that actually does bother me, because that's like saying we're all playing along with some bullshit thing, you know? Like, that's such rhetoric.
Be careful. All right, we warned the kids, now let's go smoke crack.
Yeah. You know, it's such BS, you know?
Coarse language and or themes.
Coarse language. Oh, and I suppose that's
course
my
riffs.
Fault.
Yeah, good going,
oh,
Josh.
Themes.
Nice
course
lyrics.
Themes.
Nice themes. Ding dong.
I got a theme for you.
I was wondering about one of the themes involved in the big single, New Fang. Was this, incidentally, was it an attempt to get involved in some of the vampire craze that's going on with the word fang in there? No, of course not.
Of course not.
However, was the song...
I grew up around in northern Idaho. There was a kid named Taj, and he was the only kid in this who had a mohawk in a town of 2,000 people.
Cool.
And he always used to... that's what he and his uncle used to call getting a fresh start. I'm gonna get a new fang.
Oh,
you know?
Okay.
And
nothing
then,
to do with the. Because I think I've.
No, that's what really. It was. That's what it was. Like, I get my chance and I'm gonna go in there and I'm gonna kill it this time. You know, because I got. You know, and he used to say, man, I'm gonna get me a golden fang. Like, one fang, you know?
Yeah, no, I've misread that song completely.
He's actually not alive anymore, so
I thought that song
was the philosophy.
It was about blowjobs.
Josh, in an interview.
Thanks for cheapening it.
Thank
you.
It's not cheapened. There's lyrics in there that indicate it's about blowjobs. Took turns getting carpet burns.
Yeah, there is. It's about growing up and you know, growing up being by the.
What lake. About here's your teeth back?
Oh, that's from talking
so
trash when you
Josh,
shouldn't. Doing.
Yeah, Josh punches people all the time.
So it's nothing to do with blowjobs. I'm really glad we asked that question.
Josh, in an interview you did with Austin in Austin City Limits, you described this band as secretly doing it in your parents' house.
Yep.
What do you mean by that?
Evocative.
Yeah.
I don't think I read that one.
Yeah. As what? Well, we started this
That's
band.
That's supposed to mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Come on.
This All right. Be well, good. Hey, this is easy.
Okay.
You know that excitement when you're doing it in your parents' house? Mm. You know, and you're young?
Right.
Well, this band is exciting like that, especially when nobody knew about it. It's partially that you could get caught, and partially that you want to get caught, because bad baby, bad.
I grew up in a tent.
Yeah, okay, well, then you know when you're about to get caught in your parents' two-man pup tent?
Your parents' teepee.
And just quickly, am I right in my research?
No.
Not so far.
We didn't think so. Who has daughters?
We all have daughters.
So do I.
Oh,
does anyone have sons?
No, I don't have any sons. No,
why?
Sons.
No, but I'm about
why?
To give you the moon.
That'll be good TV. Why is it that Math all hard-ass rock people have daughters? Is it punishment?
Yeah, I don't know.
Payback is a bitch, though.
Karma.
Having lived through
Karma
rock and roll
police.
Crazy days,
we've got a
now
bunch
you've got
of
daughters.
Daughters. Yeah, well.
Hey, did I tell you about my
lovely.
Idea that
your
I'm going to start a
best.
Cover band where I do Radiohead songs, country versions of them? I'm going to call it Rodeohead.
Karma Police.
And then I'm going to start a band that plays Madonna songs, heavy metal style, and I'm going to call it Madonica.
Ah!
You're the pun.
That's
Lord.
Choice. I would buy that.
Yeah, it's worth making
Straight
albums
away.
Based on a pun.
Sorry.
That's going to get digitally scrambled.
There's a bunch of people outside.
Try this for a dirty theme.
A bunch of fans outside, and also Twitter people who I've been asking, what the hell am I going to talk to you
oh,
about?
Oh, Twitter,
Twitter
that's,
people.
Don't make fun of that. That's
no, I love that.
Like
they all want to know the same thing.
Oh, I thought they had...
You want to know, is there going to be another album?
Oh.
Yeah.
Well,
from
all
of us?
Yeah.
Well, we were
probably
thin.
Another sticker.
Yeah. More stickers next
a
time.
A bigger
yeah.
sticker.
Yeah, next one won't have we moderate were, impact.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, next time we're gonna Twitter a live stream on your face party.
That's right. And you'll read about it on my set on my Facebook.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Chapter 9. Set on my Facebook.
Well, we love you all. Thank you so much for chatting.
We love you double hard. Are you coming tonight?
You want to? No, I do. I'm going back to Melbourne. I saw you on Saturday in Melbourne.
Oh.
Yeah.
How about you?
I saw you last night.
Yeah. All right, come tonight. We're coming tonight. We're going to do this.
I love your keyboarding as well. I love that
thing.
Keyboarding? Is that a key? Is that a,
no, that's what you take up to the mountain and you go,
what's the shiny thing on
no, keyboarding is when you go down a rapid road.
Is that a chaos? Yeah. Pad on there as well with the slide guitar.
On the bass lap steel.
Looks very sexy.
But,
yeah.
He only touched it once. Glowing chaos. And he touched it once and it was utter chaos. So now he's forbidden to.
We don't have to touch it anymore.
Because all of a sudden my luggage got lost and my hair was a mess. Cut!
Dudes, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you for the vultures.
I did it. You should do that.